Understood. What number I want?
What number are you looking for?
632.
We don't have to look no further.
I'm looking for my sister, Stella Dubois. I mean, Mrs. Stanley, who else?
That's the party. You just did miss ago.
This, can this be her home?
She's got the downstairs here and I got the up.
She's out.
You notice that bowling alley around the corner?
I'm not sure I did.
Well, that's where she's at, watching her husband bowl. She wasn't expecting you.
No, no, not tonight.
Well, why don't you just go in and make yourself at home till they get back?
How could I do that?
Are we on the place so I can let you in? Now, it's sort of messed up right now, but when it's clean, it's real sweet.
Is it?
Uh-huh, I think so. So you're Stella's sister?
Yes.
Think
thanks for letting me in.
Oh, Ponada. You know, as the Mexicans say, Ponada. Stella spoke of you.
Yes.
I think she let you talk school.
Yes.
And you're from Mississippi, huh?
Yes.
She showed me a picture of your home place, the plantation.
Fair Rev.
A great big place with white collars.
Yes.
A place like that must be awful hard to keep up.
If you'll excuse me, I'm just about to drop.
Oh, honey, why don't you sit down?
What I meant was I'd like to be left alone.
I'll make myself scarce in that case.
I didn't mean to be rude.
I'll drop out of the bowling alley and hustle her up.
To keep hold of myself.
Blanche!
Stella!
Oh, Stella, Stella, Stella!
Oh, now then, let me look at you. But don't you look at me, Stella. No, no, not till I've bathed and rested and turned that off, turn that overline off. I won't be looked at in this merciless glare. Come back here now. Oh, oh, Stella, Stella, for star. I thought you'd never come back to this horrible place. What am I saying? I didn't mean to say that. I meant to be nice about it and say, what a convenient location and such. Oh, precious lamb, you haven't said a word to me.
You haven't given me the chance to, honey.
Well, honey, you talk now. Open your pretty little mouth and talk. Well, I'll look around this place for some liquor. I know you must have some liquor on the place. Where could it be, I wonder? Oh, I spy, I spy.
Blanche, you sit down and let me pour the drinks. I don't know what we've got to mix with. Maybe a Coke's in the icebox.
No. Let's see, honey, hold on.
No, Coke, honey. Not tonight. Not with my nerves. Where is
Stanley?
Bowling. He loves it.
They're having a found some soda. Tournament.
Just water, baby, to chase it. Now, don't worry. Your sister hasn't turned into a drunkard. She's just all hot and shaken up and tired. Now, you sit down and explain this place to me. What are you doing in a place like this?
Now, Blanche.
Now, I'm not going to be hypocritical about it. I'm going to be honestly critical about it. Never, never in my wild dreams could I... Only Poe. Only Mr. Edgar Allan Poe could do it justice. Out there, I suppose, is the ghoul-haunted woodland of Weir.
No, honey, those are the Allan entrance.
Now, seriously, putting joking aside, why didn't you tell me? Why didn't you write me, honey? Why didn't you let me know?
Tell you what, Blanche?
Why, that you had to live in these conditions.
Aren't you being a little intense about it? It's not that bad at all. New Orleans isn't like other
cities. This has got nothing to do with New Orleans. You might as well say you're... Forgive me, blessed baby. The subject's closed.
Thanks.
You're all I've got in the world, and you're not even glad to see me.
Why, Blanche, you know that's not true.
No? I've forgotten how quiet you were.
You never did give me a chance to say much, Blanche, so I just got in the habit of being quiet around you.
Well, good habit to get into. You haven't happened to ask me how I got away from the school before the spring term ended.
I thought you'd volunteer that information if you wanted to tell me.
You thought I'd been fired?
No, I thought you might have resigned.
Well, I was so exhausted by all I'd been through. My nerves broke. I was on the verge of lunacy, almost. Mr. Graves is the high school superintendent. He suggested that I take a leave of absence. I couldn't put all those details through the wires.
Oh.
This buzzes through me and feels so good.
Won't you have
another? No, one's my limit.
Sure.
You haven't said a word about my appearance.
You're
not love you for a liar. Daylight never exposed so total a ruin. But you put on some weight, and you're just as plump as a little partridge, and it's so becoming to you.
Now, Blanche.
It is, or I wouldn't say it. You just have to watch out a little around the hips. Stand up.
Not now.
Did you hear me? I said stand up. Put in a coffin, but had to be burned like rubbish. You just came home. they don't let me go, as if you were able to stop them. The funerals are quiet, with pretty flowers, and oh, what gorgeous boxes they pack them away in. Unless you were there at the bed when they cried out, hold me, you'd never suspect there was a struggle for breath and bleeding. You didn't dare dream, Stella, but I saw. And now you sit there with your eyes telling me I let the place go. How in hell do you think all that sickness and dying was paid for, Stella? Death is expensive. And old cousin Jesse's right after Margaret turns. Why, the grim reaper had set up his tent on our doorstep. Belle Reb was his headquarters, honey. That's how it slipped through my fingers. Which one of them left us a fortune? Which one of them left us a cent of insurance even? Only poor cousin Jessie, 100 to pay for her coffin. That was all, Stella. And I, with my pitiful salary at the school. So yes, sit there and accuse me, thinking I let the place go. I let the place go? Where were you, in bed with your pole?
Blanche, you be still, that's enough.
Stella, where are you going?
Going into the bathroom to wash my face.
Oh, Stella, you're crying.
On a six-number ticket.
Now don't tell him those things, he'll believe it. Oh, hey, Mitch, when I come back here.
Hey, we play a poker tomorrow?
Oh, sure.
Mitch's? No, not in my place. My mother's still sick.
Okay, in my place. Will you bring the beer?
Hey, break it up down there. You know I made the spaghetti dish made it myself.
Oh, I told you. I phoned you. He was playing. A Jack's beer.
You never phoned me once.
I told you at breakfast and phoned you at lunch.
Never mind about that. Just get yourself home here once in a while.
Water in the papers?
You must be Stanley. I'm Blanche.
Stella's sister?
Yes.
Oh. Hello. Where's the little woman?
In the bathroom.
I didn't know you were coming to town.
I am.
Where are you from, Blanche?
Why, I live in Laurel.
In Laurel, huh?
Oh, yeah, Laurel. That's right, Laurel. Not my territory.
The liquor goes fast in the hot weather. Have a shot?
I rarely touch it.
Some people rarely touch it, but it touches them often. Oh, my clothes are sticking to me. Do you mind if I make myself comfortable?
Please do.
Be comfortable. That's my motto.
It's mine, too. It's hard to stay looking fresh. I haven't even bathed or powdered, and here you are.
You know you can catch colds sitting around in damp things? Especially when you've been exercising hard like bowling is. You're a teacher, aren't you?
Yes.
What do you teach, Blanche?
English.
Huh. Never was a very good English student. How long are you here for?
I don't know yet.
You just gonna check up here?
I thought I would, if it's not too inconvenient for you all.
Good.
Traveling wears me out.
Well, take it easy.
What was that?
Cats. Hey, Stella!
Yes, Stanley?
Haven't fallen in, have you? Well, I'm afraid I'll strike you as being the unrefined type. Stella spoke of you a good deal. She said you were married once, weren't you?
Yes. Yes, when I was quite young.
Yeah, well, what happened?
The boy died. I'm afraid I'm going to be sick.
Thank you.
hug to quiet her nerves. She's terribly upset.
Over what?
She's been through such an ordeal.
Yeah?
Stan, we've lost Belle Rev.
Place in the country?
Yes.
How?
Oh, it had to be sacrificed to something. Won't you come to make sure to say something nice about her appearance? And, oh, don't mention the baby. I haven't said anything yet. I'm waiting until she gets into a quieter condition.
So?
And try to understand her and be nice to her, Stan.
From the land of the sky blue water, they brought a captive maid.
She wasn't expecting to find us in such a small place. You see, I tried to gloss things over a little in my letters.
So?
And admire her dress and tell her she's looking wonderful. That's important with Blanche, her little weakness.
Yeah, I get the idea. Now, let's skip back a little to where you said the country place was disposed of.
Oh, yes?
Yeah, how about that? Let's have a few more details on that subject.
It's best not to talk much about it until she's calmed down.
So that's the deal, huh? Sister Blanche cannot be bothered with business details right now?
You saw how she was last night.
Well, I saw how she was. Let's have a gander at that bill of sale.
I haven't seen any.
She didn't show you no papers? No deed of sale or nothing like that, huh?
Seems like it wasn't sold.
What the hell was it then? Give away to charity?
She'll hear you.
I don't care if she hears me now. Let's see them papers.
There weren't any papers. She didn't show any papers. I don't care about papers.
Have you ever heard of the Napoleonic Code, Stella?
No, Stanley. I haven't heard of the Napoleonic Code, and if I have...
Let me enlighten you on a point or two, baby.
Yes?
In the state of Louisiana, we have what is known as the Napoleonic Code, according to which what belongs to the wife belongs to the husband also and vice versa. For instance, if I had a piece of property or you had a piece of property...
My head is swimming.
All right, I'll wait till she gets through soaking in a hot tub and then I'll inquire if she's acquainted with the Napoleonic Code. Now, it looks to me like you've been swindled, baby. And when you're swindled, under the Napoleonic Code, I'm swindled too. And I don't like to be swindled.
There's plenty of time to ask her questions later, but if you do now, she'll go to pieces again. I don't understand what happened to Belle Rev, but you have no idea how ridiculous you are being when you suggest that my sister, or I, or any one of our family could have perpetrated a swindle on anyone else.
Then where's the money if the place is sold?
Not sold. Lost. Lost. Stanley.
Open your eyes, this stuff. Think you got this on a teacher's page?
Hush.
What's this? A solid gold dress, I believe. What these here? Fox pieces. Genuine fox fur pieces, a half mile long. Where are your fox pieces, Stella? Bushes, snow white ones, no less. Where are your white fox pieces?
These are inexpensive summer furs that Blanche has had a long time.
I got an acquaintance who deals in this sort of merchandise. I'll have him in here to make an appraisal. Now, I'm willing to bet you there's thousands of dollars invested in this stuff.
Don't be such an idiot, Stanley.
And what's this? Treasure chest of a powder?
Stanley.
Or pearls. Ropes of them. Oh, what's this sister of yours? A deep sea diver? Bracelets of solid gold, too. Where are your pearls and gold bracelets?
Still, Stanley.
Oh, and diamonds, a crown for an empress.
A rhinestone tiara she wore to a costume ball.
What's rhinestone?
Next door to glass.
Are you kidding? I got an acquaintance who works in a jewelry store. I haven't been here to appraise this stuff. Here's our plantation, or what's left of it, here.
You have no idea how stupid and horrid you'll be. Close that trunk before she gets out of the bathroom.
Borowski's and the Dubois have different notions.
Indeed they have, thank heavens. I'm going outside. You come out with me while Blanche is getting dressed.
Since when do you give me orders?
Are you going to stay in here and insult her?
Damn tootin' I'm going to stay here.
Here I am, Stanley, all freshly bathed and scented and feeling like a brand new human being.
That's great, Blanche.
Excuse me while I slip on my pretty new dress.
Go right ahead, Blanche. give themselves credit for more than they got. I once went out with a doll who used to say, I am the glamorous type. I am the glamorous type. I said, so what?
And what did she say then?
She didn't say nothing. That shut her up like a clam.
Did it end the romance?
It ended the conversation. That was all. Well, some men are took in by this Hollywood glamour stuff, and some men are not.
I'm sure you belong to the second category.
That's right.
I can't imagine any witch of a woman casting a spell over you.
That's right.
You're simple, straightforward, and honest. A little bit on the primitive side, I should think to interest you, a woman would have to...
lay her cards on the table.
Well, I never cared for wishy-washy people, which is why when I saw you last night, I thought to myself, my sister has married a man. Of course, that was all I could tell
her. Now let's cut the rebar!
Stanley, you come out here and let Blanche finish dressing. I'm through dressing, honey.
Well, you come out there.
Your sister and I are having a little talk.
Stella, will you run to the drugstore and get me a lemon coke with plenty of chipped ice in it? Will you do that for me, sweetie?
Yes?
That poor thing was out there listening to us, and I have an idea she doesn't understand you as well as I do. All right, Mr. Kowalski, let us proceed without any more double talk. I'm ready to answer all questions. I've nothing to hide. What is it?
There is such a thing in the state of Louisiana as the Napoleonic Code, according to which what belongs to my wife is also mine and vice versa.
My, but do you have an impressive judicial air?
If I didn't know you was my wife's sister, I'd get ideas about you.
Such as what?
Don't play so dumb, you know what.
All right, cards on the table, that suits me. I know I fib a good deal. After all, a woman's charm is 50% illusion. But when a thing is important, I tell the truth. And this is the truth. I haven't cheated you or my sister or anyone as long as I've lived.
Where's the papers? In the trunk?
Everything I own is in that trunk. What in the name of heaven are you doing? What's in the back of that little boy's mind of yours? That I'm absconding with something? That I'm committing some sort of treachery against my sister? Let me do that. It'll be faster and simpler. I keep my papers mostly in here.
What's them underneath?
They're love letters, yellowing with antiquity, all from one boy. Give those back to me.
I'll have a look at them first.
The touch of your hands insults
them. Oh, don't pull that stuff.
Now that you've touched them, I'll burn them.
What the hell are they?
They're poems a dead boy wrote. I hurt him the way you'd like to hurt me, but you can't. I'm not young and vulnerable like my husband was. Never mind, just give those back to me.
What do you mean by saying you have to burn them?
I'm sorry. I must have lost my head for a moment. Everyone has something he doesn't want others to touch because of their intimate nature. Let me see now. Crabtree, Ambler, and Ambler. More Crabtree.
Well, what was Crabtree?
A firm that made loans on the place.
Well, then it was lost on the mortgage.
That must have been what happened.
Look, I don't want to get seen as a buster. What's all the rest of the papers?
There are thousands of papers stretching back over hundreds of years. Affecting Belrev as piece by piece on provident grandfathers, father, brothers, and uncles exchanged the land for their epic fornications, to put it plainly. That four-letter word deprived us of our plantation till all that was left, and Stella can verify that, was the house itself as well as 20 acres of ground, including a graveyard to which all but Stella and I have retreated. So here they are. All papers, I hereby endow them to you. Take them, peruse them, commit them to memory, even. I find it wonderfully fitting that this Bell Rev should finally be a bunch of old papers in your big, capable hands. I wonder if Stella's come back with my lemon coke.
I have a lawyer acquaintance, so we'll study these out.
Present them to him with a box of aspirin tablets.
You see, under the Napoleonic Code, a man has to get a certain interest in his wife's affairs. Especially now that she's going to have a baby.
Stella's going to have a baby. I didn't know Stella was going to have a baby.
bit shaky about it, but I think I handled it nicely. I laughed and treated it all as a joke. I called him a little boy and flirted. Yes, Stella, I was flirting with your husband.
The guests are gathering for the polka party. Which way do we go, Stella? This way?
No, this way. The blind are leading the blind.
Hey, Stan.
Chinamen's and bring back a load of chop suey.
Whatever I'm losing, y'all want to eat. Now, any of them, any of them. All right, openers, openers. Will you get your ass off table, Mitch? Nothing belongs on a poker table besides cards, chips, and whiskey.
Kind of on your high horse, ain't you? She don't go to bed until I come in at night.
Well, why don't you stay home with her then?
And she says to go out, so I go out. But I don't enjoy it all the while. I keep wondering how she
is. For the sake of Jesus, just go home then.
What have you got?
I got spade flush.
You know, you all are married, but I'll be alone when she goes. Now I'm going to the bathroom.
Hurry back and fix your sugar tit.
I'll go run.
Seven cards, sir. This old farmer's sitting out back of his house, throwing corn to his chickens, when all at once he hears this loud cackle, and this young hen comes running around the corner, lickety-split, and she's being chased by a rooster, and he's gaining fast.
Will you deal?
But when the rooster catches sight of the farmer throwing corn, he puts the brakes on and lets the hen get away, and starts pecking away at the corn. And the farmer says, Lord God, hope I never get that hungry!
Precision bench and the spare parts.
good. Leave it on.
Damn.
Sounds like Xavier Cugan. I didn't hear you name it.
Didn't I name it, Mitch?
I wasn't listening.
What were you doing?
He was too busy looking through them drapes. Deal the hand over again. Let's play cards and quit. Now, some people get ants when they win. Will you sit down?
I'm going to the head. Deal me out.
Oh, sure he got ants now. $7 $5 bills in his pants pockets, folded up as tight as spitballs.
Tomorrow you'll see him at the cashier's window. Get him exchanged for quarters.
And then he'll deposit them one by one in a piggy bank his mother got him for Christmas. Game spit in the ocean.
The little boy's room is busy now.
Oh. We've been drinking beer.
I hate beer.
It's a hot weather drink.
Oh, I don't think so. It always makes me warmer. Have you got any cigs?
Oh, sure.
What kind are they?
Lucky's.
Oh, good. Such a pretty case. Silver?
Yes. Yes, read the inscription.
Is there an inscription? I can't quite make it out. God choose, I shall but love thee better after death. Why, that's from my favorite sonnet by Mrs. Browning.
You know it.
Certainly I do.
Oh, there's a story connected with that inscription.
Sounds like a romance.
Pretty sad one.
Oh?
The girl's dead now.
Oh.
Well, she knew she was down when she gave me this. Very strange girl, but very sweet, I'm
very. She must have been very fond of you. Sick people have such deep, sincere attachments.
Well, that's right, they certainly didn't.
Sorrow makes for sincerity, I think.
It sure brings it out in people.
The little berries belongs to the people who have experienced some sorrow.
I believe you are right about that.
I'm positive that I am. Show me someone who hasn't known any sorrow, and I'll show you a superficial. Listen to me, my tongue is a little thick, and you boys are responsible for that. The show let out at 11, and we couldn't come home on account of the poker game. We had to go somewhere and drink. I'm not accustomed to having more than one. Two is my limit. Tonight I had three.
Mitch!
Oh, deal me out. I'm talking to Miss...
Dubois.
Miss Dubois.
It means woods, and Blanche means white. The two together mean white woods, like an orchard in the spring. You can remember me by that.
You're French.
By extraction. Our first American ancestors were French Huguenots.
You're Stella's sister, are you not?
Yes, Stella is my precious little sister. I call her little in spite of the fact that she's somewhat older than I. Not by much, less than a year. Will you do something for me?
Sure, what?
I bought this adorable little colored paper lantern at a Chinese shop on Bourbon Street. Paint over the light bulb, will you?
Be glad to.
I can't stand a naked light bulb any more than I can a rude remark from vulgar
I guess we strike you as being a pretty rough bunch.
I can be adaptable to circumstances.
Well, that's a good thing to be. You're visiting Stanley and Stella.
Yes, I came down to help Stella for a while. She's not very well. She's very run down.
Oh, you're not
married. No, I'm not married. I'm an old maid school teacher.
Oh, you may teach school, but you're certainly not an old maid.
Why, thank you, sir. I appreciate your gallantry.
So you're in the teaching profession.
Yes, yes.
Grade school or high school?
Man, coming!
I teach high school in Laurel.
Oh, what do you teach? What's up?
Yes.
I bet you teach hard on music. Well, of course, I could be wrong. You might teach arithmetic.
Oh, arithmetic, never arithmetic, sir. I don't even know my multiplication tables. I have the misfortune of being an English instructor. I intend to instill a bunch of Bobby Soxers and drugstore Romeos with reverence for Hawthorne and Whitman and Poe.
I guess some of them are more
serious.
Violets are so...
Sit down on the cigarette. Sit and have a cigarette.
I'm not properly dressed.
That will make no difference in the quarter.
Yeah.
promised me this morning that he's going to quit having these poker parties, but you know how long such a promise is going to keep. Oh, well, it's his pleasure. Like mine is moving the bridge. People have got to tolerate each other's habits, I guess.
I don't understand you. I don't understand this indifference. Is this some sort of Chinese philosophy you've cultivated?
Is what? What?
This shuffling about, mumbling beer bottles, mess in the kitchen, as if nothing out of the ordinary has happened. Are you deliberately shaking that thing in my face?
No.
Stop it. I won't let you clean up after him.
And who's going to do it, are you?
I.
No, I didn't think so.
Oh, if only my mind would function. We've got to get hold of some money. That's the way out.
I guess the money is always nice to get hold of.
Listen to me. I have an idea of some sort. Do you remember Shep Huntley?
Of course you remember Shep Huntley.
I went out with him in college for a while. Well, I ran into him on Biscayne Boulevard.
Did I tell you I went to Miami for the Christmas holiday?
No. Well, I did. I took the trip as an investment, thinking I'd meet someone with $1 million.
Did you?
Yes, I ran into Shep Huntley. I ran into him on Biscayne Boulevard on Christmas Eve around dusk. Getting into his Cadillac convertible must have been a block long.
I should think that might have been inconvenient in traffic.
You've heard of oil wells?
Yes.
Well, he has them all over Texas. Texas is literally spouting gold in his pockets.
My.
Now, you know how indifferent I am to money. I think of it in terms of what it does for you. But he could do it. He certainly could.
Do what, Blanche?
Why, set us up in a shop.
What kind of a shop?
Well, I don't know. A shop of some sort. He could do it with half of what his wife throws away at the races.
He's married?
Honey, would I be here if the man won't marry? How do I get hold of Western Union? Operator, Western Union.
That's a dial phone, honey.
I can't dial. I'm too.
Just dial O.
O?
Yes, O for operator.
Give me a pen, a slip of paper. I have to write it down first. The message, I mean. Let me see now. My darling Shep. Sister and I in desperate situation.
I beg your pardon?
Sister and I in desperate situation. Would you be interested in? Would you be interested in? Ugh, you never get anywhere with direct appeals.
Don't be so ridiculous, darling.
But I'll think of something. I've got to think of something. Don't laugh at me, honey. I want you to look at the contents of my purse. Here's what's in it. 65 measly cents in coin of the realm.
Stanley doesn't give me a regular allowance. He likes to pay bills himself, but this morning he gave me $10 to smooth things over. You take 5 of it, Blanche, and I'll keep the rest.
No, Stella, no.
I know how it helps your morale just having a little pocket money.
No, thank you. I'll take it to the streets.
Talk sense. How did you happen to get so low on funds?
Money just... It goes places. Sometime today, I've got to get hold of a bromo.
I'll fix you one now.
Not yet. I've got to keep thinking.
I wish you would just let things go, at least for a while.
Stella, I can't live with him. You can. He's your husband. But how could I stay here after last night with just those curtains between us?
Blanche, you saw him at his worst last night.
On the contrary, I saw him at his best. What such a man has to offer is animal force, and he gave a wonderful exhibition of that. But the only way to live with such a man is to go to bed with him, and that's your job, not mine.
After you've rested a little, you'll see things are going to work out. You won't have to worry about anything while you're here. I mean, expenses.
I have to plan for us both to get us both out.
You take it for granted that I'm in something that I want to get out of.
I take for granted that you still have sufficient memory of Belle Reve to find this place and these poker players impossible to live with.
Well, you are taking entirely too much for granted.
I can't believe you're in earnest.
No?
I mean, I understand how it happened a little. You saw him, an officer in uniform, not here.
I'm not sure it would have made any difference where I saw him.
Now, don't say it's one of those mysterious electric things that happens between people. If you do, I'll laugh in your face.
I'm not going to say anything more at all about it.
All right, fine, then don't.
But there are things that happen between a man and a woman in the dark that sort of make everything else seem
you are talking about is desire. Just brutal desire. The name of that rattle-trap streetcar that bangs through the quarter, up one narrow street and down the other.
Haven't you ever ridden on that streetcar?
It brought me here, where I am not wanted and where I am ashamed to be.
Then don't you think your superior attitude is just a bit out of place?
Well, I'm not being or feeling superior at all. Believe me, I'm not. It's just, this is how I see it. A man like that is someone to go out with once, twice, three times, maybe, if the devil is in you. But to live with? To have a child by?
I have told you I love him.
Then I tremble for you. I just tremble for you.
I can't help your trembling if you insist on trembling.
May I speak plainly?
Yes? Go ahead and plainly.
Forgive me, he's common.
Why, yes, I suppose he is.
Suppose? You can't have forgotten that much about bringing up that you suppose any part of a gentleman's in his nature. Not one particle, no. Oh, if he were plain and ordinary, but good and wholesome, but no, there's something downright bestial about him. You hate me saying this, aren't you?
Go on and say it all, Blanche.
He acts like an animal. Has an animal's habits, eats like one, moves like one, talks like one. There's something subhuman about him, something not quite to the stage of humanity. Yes, something ape-like, like one of those pictures I've seen in the anthropological studies. Thousands and thousands of years have passed him by, and there he is, Stanley Kowalski, survivor of the Stone Age, bearing the raw meat home from the kill in the jungle. And you here, waiting for him. Maybe he'll strike you, or maybe he'll grunt and kiss you. That is, if kisses have been discovered yet. Nightfall, and the other apes gather all at the front of the cave with him, grunting and swilling and gnawing and hulking. His poker night, you call it, this party of apes. Someone growls and someone snatches at something and the fight is on. God, Stella, maybe we are all a long way from being made in God's image, but Stella, my sister, some progress has been made since then. Such things as art, as poetry, as music, some kinds of new light have come into the world since then. And some people, some tenderer feelings, have had some little beginning that we have got to cling to and make grow and hold as our flag in this dark march toward whatever it is we're approaching. Don't hang back.
Hey, Stella!
Stand, Stella.
Hi, Stella. Is Blanche back?
Yes, she's back.
Oh, hi, Blanche.
You must have gotten under the car.
Oh, them damn mechanics at Fritz's don't know the ass from the... Hey!
time were you born?
Why, my birthday is next month, the 15th of September. That's under Virgo.
What's Virgo?
Virgo is the virgin.
Say, do you know somebody named Shaw?
Why, everybody knows somebody named Shaw.
Well, there's somebody named Shaw is under the impression he met you once in law. I figured he must have gotten mixed up with some other party. Because this other party is someone he met at a hotel called the Flamingo.
Yes, yes, he must have gotten me mixed up with this other party. The Hotel Flamingo is not the sort of establishment I would dare to be seen in.
Oh, you know?
Yes, I've seen it and smelled it.
You must have gotten pretty close and you can smell it.
The odor of cheap perfume is penetrating.
The stuff you use is expensive?
Yes, $25 an ounce. I'm almost out. That's a hint if you want to remember my birthday.
Shaw must have gotten you mixed up. He goes through law all the time so he can check on it and clear up any mistakes. I'll wait for you at the Four Deuces.
Hey, don't I red one kiss?
Not in front of your sister.
Stella, what have you heard about me?
Huh?
What have people been telling you about me?
Telling?
You haven't heard any unkind gossip about me?
Why, no, Blanche, of course not.
Honey, there was a good deal of talk back in Laurel.
About you, Blanche?
I wasn't so good the last 2 years or so after Belgrade started to slip through my fingers.
All of us do things that we...
I never was hard or self-sufficient enough. When people are soft, soft people have to shimmer and glow and wear soft colors, the colors of butterfly wings, and take a paper lantern over the light. I'm not enough to be soft. You have to be soft and attractive. And I'm fading now, and I don't know how much longer I can turn the trick.
Have you even been listening to me?
I don't listen to you when you're being morbid. Is that coke for me?
Not for anyone else.
You precious thing, you. Is it just coke?
You mean you want a shot in it?
Well, honey, a shot never did coke any harm, but let me. You must wait on me.
I like to wait on you, Blanche. It makes me feel more like home.
I love to be waited on. You're so good to me, and I know you hate it when I talk sentimental, but believe me, honey, I feel things more than I tell you, and I won't, I promise. I'll go. I'll go soon. I will, really. I won't hang around here till he throws me out.
Will you stop talking foolish?
Yes, honey, watch how you pour that. That fizzy stuff foams over. Oh! All over my pretty skirt!
Oh, you might be black gently.
Yes, gently.
Why did you scream like that?
I don't know why I screamed. Mitch is coming over tonight at 7, and I guess I'm just nervous about our relations. He hasn't gotten anything but a good night kiss, Stella. That's all I've given him. I want his respect, and men don't want anything they can get too easy. On the other hand, men lose interest quickly, especially when a girl is over 30. They say a girl over 30 ought to, the vulgar term is put out, but I'm not going to put out. Of course, he doesn't know that. I haven't informed him of my real age.
Why are you sensitive about your age?
Because of the hard knocks my bandy's been given. What I mean is, he thinks I'm sort of prim and proper. I want to deceive him enough to make him want me.
Do you want him, Blanche?
I want to rest. I want to breathe easy again. Yes, I want Mitch. Very badly. Just think, if it works out, I can leave here and not be any.
you're tired.
Even the hot tamale man has deserted the street and he hangs on till the end. How will you get home?
I'll walk over to Bourbon and catch an owl car.
Is that streetcar named Desire still grinding along the tracks at this hour?
I'm afraid you haven't gotten much fun out of this evening, Blanche.
I spoiled it for you.
No, you didn't, but I felt all the time that I wasn't giving you much entertainment.
I simply couldn't rise to the occasion, that's all. I've never tried so hard in my life to be gay and made such a dismal mess of it. I'll get 10 points for trying, though. I did try.
Why did you try if you didn't feel like it, Blanche?
Well, I was just obeying the law of nature.
Which law is that?
The law that says a lady must entertain a gentleman, or no dice. Will you look in my purse and try and locate my door key? When I'm this tired, my fingers are all thumbs.
This it?
No, honey, that's the key to my trunk, which I must soon be packing.
You mean you're leaving here soon?
I've outstayed my welcome.
This it?
Eureka! Honey, you get the door while I take one last look at the sky. I'm looking for the Pleiades, the Seven Sisters. Those girls aren't out tonight. Yes, they are. There they are. God bless them all in a little bunch on the way home from their bridge party. Did you get the door? Good boy. I guess you want to go now.
Can I kiss you goodnight?
Why do you always ask if you may?
I don't know whether you want me to or not.
Why should you be so doubtful?
Well, that night we parked by the lake and I kissed you.
Honey, it wasn't the kiss I objected to. It was the other little familiarity that I felt obligated to discourage. I didn't resent the kiss, not a bit in the world. In fact, I was somewhat flattered that you desired me. But honey, you know as well as I do that a single girl, a girl alone in the world, has got to keep a firm hold on her emotions or she'll be lost.
Lost?
I guess you're used to girls that like to get lost immediately on the first date.
I like you to be exactly the way that you are. Because in all my experience, I've never known anyone like you. Are you laughing at me?
No, honey. The lord and lady of the house have not yet returned. Come in, let's have a nightcap, shall we? Let's leave the lights off.
You just do what you want to.
The other room's more comfortable. We'll go in there. This crashing around in the dark is my search for some liquor.
You want a drink?
No, I want you to have a drink. You've been so anxious and solemn all night. We've both been so anxious and solemn. And now for these last few remaining moments of our lives together, I want to create joie de vie. I'm lighting a candle.
That's good.
We're going to be very bohemian about it. We'll pretend that we are on the left bank in Paris in a little artist's cafe. Je suis en avant, comme vous et moi. Understand, French?
Oh, no, no.
Vous allez vous coucher avec moi ce soir? Damn good thing. I found some liquor, honey. Just enough for two shots without any dividends.
That's good.
Why don't you take off your coat and loosen your collar?
I better leave it on.
No, I want you to be comfortable.
I'm ashamed of the way I perspire. My shirt is sticking to me.
Perspiration is healthy. If a person didn't perspire, they'd die in 5 minutes. It's a nice coat. What kind of material is it?
Oh, well, they call that stuff alpaca.
Ooh, alpaca.
It's very lightweight alpaca.
Lightweight alpaca?
I don't like to wear a washcoat, even in summer, because I sweat through it.
Oh.
And it don't look neat on me. A man with a heavy build has got to be careful of what he puts on him so he don't look too clumsy.
You are not too heavy.
You don't think I am?
Well, you're not the delicate type. You have a massive bone structure and a very imposing physique.
Thank you. Last Christmas, I was given a membership to the New Orleans Athletic Club.
Oh, good.
Oh, it was the finest present I was ever given. I work out there with the weights, and I swim and keep myself fit. When I started there, I was getting soft in the belly, but now my belly is hard. Oh, it's so hard now that a man can punch me in the belly and it don't hurt me. Punch me, go on, see?
Oh, gracious.
Guess how much I weigh, Blanche?
Oh, I don't know. I'd say somewhere in the vicinity of 180.
Guess again.
Not that much?
No, more.
Well, you're a tall man. You can carry a good deal.
6'1½" tall and with bare feet, without shoes on, and that's what I wear stripped.
My goodness me, it's all inspiring.
My weight is not a very interesting subject to talk about. What's yours? Yes.
Yes.
Let me lift you.
Samson, God lift me. Well.
You're as light as a feather.
You may unhand me, sir.
Huh?
I said release me. Now, Mitch, just because Stanley and Stella aren't home is no reason why you shouldn't behave like a gentleman.
Well, just give me a slap whenever I step out of bounds.
That won't be necessary. You're a natural gentleman. One of the very few left in the world. Now, I don't want you to think I'm all severe or old maid school teacherish or anything like that. It's just, I guess I...
Huh?
I guess I just have old-fashioned ideals.
Oh. Where's Stanley and Stella tonight?
I believe they went out with Mr. and Mrs. Hubble upstairs.
Where'd they go?
A midnight preview at Low State.
Well, we shall go out together some night.
No, I don't think that would be a very good idea.
Well, why not?
You and Stanley are old friends.
We was together in the 241st.
So he talks to you frankly?
Sure.
What's he said about me?
Oh, not very much.
From the way you say it, it sounds like he has.
No, he hasn't said much.
But from what he has said, what would you say his attitude toward me was?
Why do you want to ask that?
Well...
Don't you get along with him?
What do you think?
I don't think he understands you.
He's insufferably rude. If it weren't for Stella about to have a baby, I wouldn't be able to endure things here.
But he isn't nice to you?
He goes out of his way to offend me.
In what way, Blanche?
Why, in every conceivable way.
I'm surprised to hear that.
Are you?
I don't see how anybody could be rude to you.
It's really a pretty frightful situation. There's no privacy here. There's just this portier between the two rooms at night. He stalks through the two rooms in his underwear at night. I have to ask him to close the bathroom door. That sort of commonness isn't necessary. You probably wonder why I don't move out. I'll tell you frankly. A teacher's salary is barely enough to cover her living expenses. I didn't save a penny last year, which is why I had to come here and put up with my sister's husband. And why he has to put up with me, apparently, so much against his wishes. Surely he must have told you how much he hates me.
I don't think he hates you.
He hates me, or why would he insult me? The moment I laid eyes on him, I thought, this man is my executioner. This man is going to destroy me.
Blanche?
Yes, honey?
Can I ask you a question?
What?
How old are you?
Why do you want to know my age?
I talked to my mother about you and she said, no, this Blanche, and I wasn't able to tell her.
You talked to your mother about me?
Yes.
Why?
Oh, I told my mother how nice you were and I liked you.
Were you sincere about it?
Oh, you know I was.
Why did your mother want to know my age?
Mother is sick.
I'm sorry to hear it. Badly?
She won't live long. Maybe just a few months. She worries about me because I'm not settled. She wants me to settle down before she...
You love her very much, don't you?
Yes.
I think you have a great capacity for devotion. You're going to be very lonely when she passes, won't you? I know what that is.
To be lonely?
Yes. I loved someone once, and the person I loved, I lost.
Dead? A man?
He was a boy. Just a boy when I was a very young girl. When I was 16, I made the discovery. Love. All at once and much, much too completely. It was like you suddenly turned a blinding light on something that had always been half in shadow. That's how it struck the world for me. But I was unlucky. Deluded. There was something different about the boy. A nervousness, a softness, a tenderness that wasn't anything like a man's. Although he wasn't the least bit effeminate looking at all, still, that thing was there. I didn't know that. I didn't find out anything until after we were married and had come back. And all I knew was that I'd failed him in some mysterious
room that I thought was empty, which wasn't empty, but had two people in it. The boy I had married and an older man who had been his friend for years.
I need somebody too. Could it be you and me, Blanche?
Sometimes there's God so quickly.
Hotel called the Flamingo.
Say it's only a paper moon sailing over.
stayed there too.
My sister lived at Bell Rev.
This was after the whole place slipped through her lily white fingers. She moved to the Flamingo, a second-class hotel that has the advantage of not interfering in the private social lives of the personalities there. Now, the Flamingo was used to all kinds of goings-on, but even the management at the Flamingo was impressed by Dame Blanche. In fact, they were so impressed by Dame Blanche, they requested she turn in her room key for permanently. This was a couple of weeks before she showed here. Sure, I can see how this would upset you. Now, she pulled the wool over your eyes as much as Mitch's.
It's pure invention. There's not a word of truth in it. And if I were a man and this creature had dared to invent such things in my presence... Without your love, it's a
honky-tonk parade. Honey, I thoroughly checked on all these stories. Now wait till I finish. The trouble with Dame Blanche was that she couldn't keep on her act anymore in Laurel. They got wised up after two or three dates and then they quit. And she goes on to another. Same old lines, same old act, same old hooey. But the town was too small for this to go on forever. As time went by, she became a town character, regarded as not just different, but downright loco nuts. And for the last year or two, she's been washed up like poison. That's why she's here this summer, visiting royalty, putting on all this act, because she's practically told by the mayor to get out of town. Yes, did you know there's an army camp near Laurel, and your sister's place is one of the places called Out of Bounds?
It's a fun on the daily world, just as funny as it can be. Stella? Yes, Blanche? Will you give me a bath towel to dry my hair with? I just washed it. Yes, Blanche.
How soon's that gonna be?
Not too terribly long, because that's your soul in patience.
It's not my soul, it's my kidneys I'm worried about. Well, what do you think of it?
I don't believe all those stories, and I think your supply man was mean and rotten to tell them. It's possible that some of the things he said are partly true. There are things about my sister I don't approve of, things that cause sorrow at home. She was always flighty. But when she was young, very young, she married a boy who wrote poetry. He was extremely good looking. I think Blanche didn't just love him, but worshiped the ground he walked on. Adored him and thought him almost too fine to be human. But then she found out.
What?
This beautiful and talented young man was a degenerate. Didn't your supply man give you that information?
All we talked about was recent history. That must have been a pretty long time ago.
Yes, it was a pretty long time ago.
How many candles are putting in that cake?
I'll stop at 25.
Is company expected?
We asked Mitch to come over for cake and ice cream.
I wouldn't be expecting Mitch over tonight.
Why?
Mitch is a buddy of mine. We was in the same outfit together. 241st Engineers. We work at the same plant and now on the same bowling team. You think I could face him?
Did you repeat what that?
You're goddamn right, I told him. I'd have that on my conscience the rest of my life if I knew all that stuff and let my best friend get caught.
Is Mitch through with her?
Wouldn't you
be? I said, is Mitch through with her?
No, not necessarily through with her. He just wised up.
Stanley, she thought Mitch was going to marry her. I was hoping so, too.
Well, he's not going to marry her. Maybe he was, but he's not going to jump in the tank with a school full of sharks now. Oh, Blanche, can I please get in my bathroom?
Yes, indeed, sir. Can you wait one moment while I dry?
Haven't waited 1 hour, one moment ought to pass in a hurry.
And she hasn't got her job? Well, what'll she do?
She's not staying here past Tuesday. You know that, don't you?
just to make sure I got a bus ticket myself.
If in the first place, Blanche wouldn't go on a bus.
Oh, she'll go on a bus in my
head. No, she won't. No, she won't.
She'll go, period. P.S. She goes Tuesday.
What'll she do? What on earth will she do?
Her future's all mapped out for her.
What do you mean?
Hey, Canary Bird, quick, go to the bathroom!
What is it?
What? Nothing's happened, Blanche.
You're lying. Something has.
Magnolia 9047. Yes, tell him to call back. It's very important. Yes, thank you.
Stella, it's going to be all
like two blue candles lighted in a white cake.
What poetry?
I shouldn't have called him.
There's lots of things could have happened.
There's no excuse for it, Stella. I won't put up with the insult. I won't be taken for granted.
God damn, it's hot in here with the steam from that bathroom.
I said I was sorry 3 times. I take hot baths for my nerves. Hydrotherapy, they call it. You help a Polack without a nerve in your body. You wouldn't understand what anxiety...
I am not a Polack. People from Poland are Poles, not Polacks. What I am is 100% American. Born and raised in the greatest country on this earth and proud as hell of it. So don't you ever call me a Polack.
That's for me. I'm
sure. I'm not sure. Keep your seat. Hello? Oh, yeah. Hello, Mac.
Stella, get your hands off me. Why are you looking at me with that pitying...
Quiet in there! Now, we got a noisy woman on place. Go ahead, Mac. At Riley's? No, I don't want to bowl at Riley's. I had a run-in with Riley last week. Well, I'm the team captain, ain't I? All right, so I'm not going to bowl at Riley's. We'll bowl at the west side of the gala. All right, Mac, I'll see you soon. Sister Blanche? I got a little birthday remembrance for you.
Do you, Stanley? I wasn't expecting it. I don't know why Stella wants to observe my birthday when you reach 27. Age is a subject you'd much prefer to ignore.
27.
What is it? Is it for me?
Yes, I hope you like it.
Why? Why, it's a...
Ticket. Back to Laurel on the Greyhound Tuesday. Well.
You didn't need to do that.
Don't forget all that I took off her.
You needn't have been so cruel to someone alone as she is.
Delicate piece she is.
She is. She was. You didn't know Blanche as a girl. Nobody. Nobody was tender and trusting as she was. But then people like you abused her and forced her to change. Do you think you're going bowling now?
Sure.
You're not going bowling. Why did you do this to her?
Look, no, I didn't do nothing to no one.
Never mind.
Never want to go out till after six, and then it's always someplace that's not lighted much.
There is some obscure meaning in this, but I failed to catch it.
What it means is I've never had a real good look at you, Blanche. Let's turn the light on here.
What light? What for?
This one, with the paper thing on it.
What did you do that for?
So I could have a look at you good and plain.
Surely you don't mean to be insulting.
No, just realistic.
I want realism. I want magic. Yes, yes, magic. I try to create that for people. I misrepresent things to them. I don't tell truth. I tell what ought to be truth. And if that's sinful, then let me be damned for it. Don't turn that light on!
I don't mind you being older than what I thought. But all the rest of it. Christ, that pitch about your ideals being so old-fashioned. All the malarkey you've dished out all of a sudden. I knew. You weren't 16 anymore, but I was fool enough to believe you were straight.
I told you I wasn't straight. My loving brother-in-law, and you believed him.
I called him a liar at first, and then I checked on the store. First, I asked our supply man, who travels directly through Laurel, and then I spoke directly over long distance to this merchant.
Who is this merchant?
Kieferber.
The merchant Kieferber of Laurel. I know the man. He whistled at me, and I put him in his place. And now to seek revenge, he makes up stories about me.
Three people, Kieferber, Stanley, and Shaw, swore to them.
Robert Dove, three men in a tub, and in such a filthy tub.
Didn't you stay at a hotel called the Flamingo?
Flamingo? No. I stayed at a hotel called the Tarantula. The Tarantula Arms.
Tarantula?
Yes, a big spider. That's where I took my victims. I had many intimacies with strangers. After the death of Alan, intimacies with strangers was all I seemed to be able to fill my empty heart with. I think it was panic, just panic that drove me from one to another, hunting for some kind of protection. In the most unlikely places, even at last, in a 17-year-old boy. Somebody wrote the superintendent, "This woman is morally unfit for her position." Unfit, yes, somehow. Anyway, but there was nowhere left for me to go, so I came here. I was played out. You know what played out is? My youth had gone up the water spout. Then I met you. You seemed to be gentle. A cleft in the rock of the world I can hide out in. You said you needed somebody, and I needed somebody too. I thank God for you. But I guess I was asking, hoping for too much. Kieferber, Stanley, and Shaw tied an old tin can to the tail of the kite.
You lied to me, Blanche.
Don't say I lied to you.
Lies. Lies inside and out. All lies.
But inside, I didn't lie in my heart. Crumble and fade and regrets, recriminations. If you'd done this, it wouldn't have cost me that. Legacies and other things such as blood-stained pillow slips. Her linen needs changing. Yes, mother, but couldn't we get a colored girl to do it? No, of course we couldn't. Everything was gone but the death. I used to sit here and she would sit there and death was as close as you are, but neither of us would dare admit we'd seen it. The opposite is desire. So do you wonder, how can you wonder? Not far from Belrev, before we lost Belrev, was a camp where they would train young soldiers. On Saturday nights, they would go into town and get drunk, and afterwards they would stagger into my lawn and call, "Blanche! Blanche!" The deaf old lady inside suspected nothing. Sometimes I would answer their call. Later, the paddy wagon would gather them up like daisies, the long way home. What do you want?
What I've been missing all summer.
Then marry me, Mitch.
No, I don't think I want to marry you anymore.
No?
You're not clean enough to bring into the house with my mother.
Then leave. Get out of here quick before I start screaming fire! Get out of here quick before I start screaming fire! 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 Fire!
Thank you. if anyone's sober enough to drive a car. But you have to be careful to dive where the deep pool is. If you hit on a rock and you don't come up till tomorrow.
Till morning, so they told me to go home and get a little shut-eye.
Does that mean we're to be alone here?
Yeah, just you and me, Blanche. Unless you got someone hid under the bed. What do you got on those fine feathers for?
That's right, you left before my wire came.
We got a wire?
Yes, I received a telegram from an old admirer of mine.
Anything good?
Oh, I think so, an invitation.
What to, a fireman's ball?
A cruise of the Caribbean on a yacht.
Well, what do you know?
I've never been so surprised in my life.
I guess not.
It came like a bolt from the blue.
What'd you say it was from again?
An old beau of mine.
The one that gave you the fox pieces?
Mr. Shep Huntley, I wore his ATO pin my last year at college. I hadn't seen him until last Christmas. And then, just now, this wire, inviting me on a cruise of the Caribbean. The trouble now is clothes. I've torn through my trunk to find something suitable to wear in the tropics.
And come up with that gorgeous diamond tiara.
This old relic? It's only rhinestone.
Gosh, I thought it was Tiffany diamonds.
Yes, well, I will be entertained in style.
Uh-huh, well, I guess it goes to show you never know what's coming.
Just when I thought my luck had begun to fail me.
Into the picture pops this Miami millionaire.
This man is not from Miami. This man is from Dallas.
This man's from Dallas?
Yes, this man is from Dallas, where gold spouts out of the ground.
Well, just so he's from somewhere.
Close the curtains before you undress any further.
Oh, this is all a little undressing now. Seen a bottle opener? I used to have this cousin who could open beer bottles with his teeth. All he could do, his only accomplishment, he was a human bottle opener. This one time, at a wedding party, he broke off his front teeth. He was so ashamed of himself, he used to sneak out of the house whenever company came. Rain from heaven! Should we bury the hatchet and make a loving cup?
No, thank you.
Well, I guess it's a red letter night for the both of us. You having an oil millionaire, me having a baby.
What are you doing in here?
Here's something I always pull out on special occasions like this. Silk pajamas I wore on my wedding night.
Oh.
When they call and say you got a son, I'm going to tear them off and wave them like a flag. I guess we're both entitled to put out the dog.
When I think of how divine it is going to be to have such a thing as privacy once more, I could weep with joy.
This millionaire isn't going to interfere with his privacy then?
Not like anything you have in mind. This man is a gentleman and respects me. What he wants is my companionship. Having great wealth sometimes makes people lonely, and a cultivated woman, a woman of intelligence and breeding, can enrich a man's life immeasurably. And I have those things, and this doesn't take that away. Physical beauty is passing, a transitory possession. But beauty of the mind and richness of the spirit and tenderness of the heart, and I have those things, aren't taken away, but increased, grow with the years. How strange that I should be called a destitute woman when I have so many treasures locked in my heart. I think of myself as a very, very rich woman. But I have been foolish casting my pearl for swine.
Swine, huh?
Swine, yes. The swine. And I'm thinking not only of you, but of your friend, Mr. Mitchell.
in your running luck.
You want to know what luck is? Luck is believing you're lucky. Take it to Salerno. I believed I was lucky. I figured 4 out of 5 of us would not return, but I would and I did. I put that down as a rule. To hold a front position in this rat race, you gotta believe you're lucky.
You. Brag. Bull.
What's the matter with him?
I always did say that men are callous things for no feelings. This does beat anything. Make pigs themselves.
What's the matter with her?
How is my baby?
Sleeping like a little angel. I brought you some grapes.
Yes, it'll do. I'm anxious to get out of here. This place is a trap.
Game of seven card stud.